Logan Lerman has been around in movies longer than you think. Before he was a teen idol, in movies like Perks of Being a Wallflower and Percy Jackson, Lerman's cute 8-year-old face graced our screens in The Patriot as one of Mel Gibson's sons. So far in his career, he's done enough that he can look back and rightly claim to have a very impressive resume. Get to know him better with these 10 things you probably didn't know about Logan Lerman. He had an agent at the age of 4. This isn't too surprising, since by the age of 2.5, he'd already told his mother that he wanted to be an actor. That's rather impressive, since a lot of us at 2 years old were still parked in front of the TV, watching cartoons and babbling excitedly about what we just watched, or going off to emulate them in some way, only to realize that we weren't quite as skilled as the people on TV. He's managed by his mother. It would be a big boost for anyone if the person managing them knew them so well. No one knows you better than your parents most times, so it's easy to see that his mother could follow his progress and determine when he needs a break or if he can keep going. It might put a strain on their relationship at times, but it would keep them closer as well, it would seem. Early life. Logan Lerman was born in Beverly Hills, California on January 19, 1992, to Lisa, who works as his manager, and Larry Lerman, a businessman and orthotist. His parents are both Jewish. He has 2 elder siblings named Lindsay and Lucas. Lerman has stated that he is a black sheep in the household because he is an actor, while most of his relatives work in the medical profession. He chose acting over the family business, prosthetics. At a young age, his surroundings influenced him to pursue acting as a career path. He told Just Jared, "I think we're all products of where we're from, and I'm from Los Angeles, which if you look at it, the only culture there is Hollywood. I guess that probably had a big influence on the reason I like movies so much." On his first ever appearance on Jimmy Kimmel Live, the talk show host brought up the website of his family's prosthetic business, operating in Southern California since 1915. Although Lerman's father joined the prosperous business, he never pressured his son to follow in his footsteps. Lerman told Kimmel, "No, I wasn't really pressured at all. I mean, I was acting so young. But I think they wanted me to. I'm sure that they did." He was the younger version of Ashton Kutcher in The Butterfly Effect. This movie does a lot of back and forth, as Evan moves along his own personal timeline, so there was a lot of use for Lerman when it came to showing young Evan and just what was happening to disrupt his life. The movie itself was well developed, but instead of becoming a mainstream classic, became more of a cult classic that didn't get a lot of play after it was released on DVD. He played a fantasy hero. For the 2010 movie adaptation of the Rick Riordan book series, Percy Jackson and the Olympians, The Lightning Thief, Lerman won the titular role. In 2013, he was in the sequel, Percy Jackson and the Olympians, Sea of Monsters. He bonded with his castmates, Alexandra Daddario and Brandon T. Jackson. He told Just Jared about his co-stars turned friends. "Most of us worked together in the first one. We were all tight, and we didn't really have anybody that we disliked on the first film. And then we had our new additions, Levin Rambin and Douglas Smith, who were there like the whole time, really. They're good guys. We had fun together. It was fun and very light on set." He's appeared in 2 films with Mel Gibson in the same year. He played Gibson's son in The Patriot and the younger version of Gibson in What Women Want. There's an advantage to being the young person on the set when it comes to sharing timelines. Plus, it afforded him yet another chance to be in the presence of known and experienced actors that he could watch and possibly learn from. Thanks to his agent, he's had a lot of help in his career. He was considered for the role of Romeo in Romeo and Juliet. His popularity is increasing day by day. As a reputed actor, he was offered the role of Romeo in Romeo and Juliet in 2013. But later, this role was taken by Douglas Booth. He was also offered to play the role of Peter Parker / Spider-Man in the movie The Amazing Spider-Man. He's a classical composer. The actor has an ear for music. This talent follows him on set, and he is known to write music for his co-stars. During the filming of The Perks of Being a Wallflower, he even wrote Emma Watson a song. She told Sugarscape, "Logan's actually like a classical composer. He actually composed a piece of music for his part in Perks, and he's composed a piece of music for me, and for Ezra. So he's very talented." His biggest ambition is to direct. This seems to be the direction that a lot of actors, both young and old, have decided to take when they finally reach the point where they want to do something else. Some actors make the transition quickly, but Lerman is patiently waiting for his day to come, as he continues to use acting as a springboard towards his real goal,